Rosa. Ich would write more, but my heart is kaput.
Your legs will be kaput in a minute, Sophie.
Oh, show a bit of sensitivity, Sophie.
Sensitivity? They don't teach me that at my cheap old school.
Flaming heck, Dad. A bit of notice would have been nice.
I'm getting tired of your lips. Sorry.
No, I didn't mean it like that. And Sally will be fine. And the kids will be made up.
What is he coming to say? Oh, boss, I love my granddad.
So what time are you coming? No, oh, don't be daft. It'll either be me or Tyrone. I'm the good-looking one. All right, I'll see you later, Dad.
When's it coming?
4 o'clock.
Today?
I know.
Oh, it might have warned us. Hey, Rosie, stop pining. Make yourself useful. That bathroom could do with a good scrub.
Hello? What happened to sensitivity?
Now, please. And if you don't fancy going to school, Sophie, you can stay at home and help your sister clean the house from top to bottom.
Yeah, all right. See you later, Dad.
Mm. Oh, come on! What are you waiting for?
Sal, it's me dad. He's not expecting Buckingham Palace.
And for me, right, Grandad is just a reminder of the whole Paris scenario.
I know, love. And make sure you bleach under the rim.
Hey, Grandad!
How are you doing?
How are you doing? You all right?
Good, yeah, yeah.
Mum! My Grandad's here!
Hiya!
Hiya!
Oh. Hey, do you know what? This place hasn't changed a bit.
We've done a bit of work on our lounge diner.
Oh, yeah?
And I put a nice tea on for you.
Oh, great. Hey, Kev, I could murder a pint. Do you want to join me?
Oh, fancy coming, sir?
No, I'm doing the cooking. You're not going to be long, are you?
No, just the one, promise.
Yeah.
Mum, I'm not eating this. I can't. I'll heave.
I'm a bit physiocastogenic. Well, don't blame me. Blame your dad. Not bad with a bit of ketchup on it.
Look, I'm sorry, Sal. It's just... Well, my dad took a shine to the new barmaid.
Oh, I'm not supposed to make everything all right, is it? I told you I was making a nice tea, and look at it, it's ruined. I hope you're not going to be dragging him off to the pub every night, Bill. That Michelle is young enough to be your granddaughter.
Bill's minging!
I tell you what, I can make some sarnies.
Kevin, you might cut yourself, because you're actually still quite drunk.
Look, why don't I go and get 5 fish suppers?
Oh, can you make mine a cheese and onion pie? And veggie. And Grandad, please, can I have a sausage as well? Because I'm greedy.
Come on, Sal. Hey, look, I'm really sorry I spoiled your night. How about some nice cod, hey, swimming in vinegar?
Oh, go on, then. But, Kevin, what have chips?
Well, they're not.
No, you'll have a nice big slab of humble pie. Oh, Mr. Baldwin's there. I'm going to be late.
Oh, I mean it, Mum. I could not go to dance again wearing my scruffy shoes.
Well, you're bound to get some money for your birthday, love. Here, you can buy some then.
Well, that's not fair. Right, well, I've got an old pair that'll fit you.
There you go. See you later.
I'm sorry, right, but, like, Mr. Spence will be all impressed with me if I turn up looking all mingy.
My feet do not smell.
Who's Mr. Spence?
Dad, I told you last night.
New dance teacher. Replaced Mrs. Dunstan, who left to have a baby. All you have to do is listen. Hey, Cinderella, you will go to the ball.
What's your name, then?
One way to find out.
Hey, hang on, if that's a present, you can wait till your birthday.
Hey, they're a grandad present. Different to a birthday present.
Grandad, thank you! Oh, thank you, perfect!
You didn't think I'd forget you, did you? It's a voucher. Didn't want to risk buying clothes for her.
Oh, cool. Excuse me, missus. Thank you very much.
Oh, Bill, you shouldn't.
Hey, don't go on, Sal. I've got a lot of catching up in the spoiling and rotten steaks to do. Oh, yeah.
Are you drunk, Grandad?
No, lovey, but I was last night.
So where did you go?
Don't remember.
Oh, I bet you don't, Kevin. You didn't come in till 5 o'clock.
Well, yeah, I spotted a few old mates.
What, in the cemetery?
Ain't cheeky.
She's not cheeky, she's lovely. Hey, Sophie, give your old granddad a kiss.
Anyway, you met these mates?
Yeah.
That you haven't seen for ages?
Yeah.
And you went for a drink?
Yeah.
You were in the pub all night.
Well, sort of. It was a drinking club. Members only.
These cards are just beyond childish. Oh, boo-hoo, I can bother.
But you're not a member of any clubs.
I am now.
Hello, Molly. Tyrone not with you?
No, not likely. He's grounded. And this pair should be in all. They're his partners in crime.
Crime?
Hey, we did nothing illegal.
When?
Look, keep some. The least said the better.
Well, what have you done?
Nothing. Will someone change the subject, please?
Yeah. Molly, what have they got up to? I want to know.
Would you believe lap dancing?
What's lap dancing?
Well, it's summer dirty old men do on a night out, that's what.
Hey, wait till our Rosie hears about this one.
Kevin, is that right?
Look, it was me dad's idea.
Yeah, well, I don't doubt it was, but this one is...
Oh, that's a rabbit, sir. Come on, go
on.
I'll tell you what, our Kevin, I could tell him of his life.
What about poor Tyrone, confined to barracks?
Hey, believe me, it wouldn't change a thing. I could check you one night if you like. Don't I, Uncle?
Oh! Yesterday.
Nothing new there, then.
It's that little one I feel sorry for. Pushed at him. Pillar to post. What is Tracy thinking of?
Is Lush? People still say Lush.
Hey, Sal, that's a private thought you broadcast in here.
Mr. Spence is well fit. Oh, Sophie, you're in love with your dance teacher, Mr. Spence.
No!
Have you never been in love, Sal? She's very sensitive, that girl.
Oh, well, she's living in the wrong house, Bill. Don't worry, I'll go up in a minute.
No, I'll go. I am perhaps, me and Kath could go down the road later on.
Sorry, mate. I'm grounded.
Oh, come on, you ain't gonna pass out for half an hour. Chitty, off matron.
Hey, watch it, Bill.
This cobble's a man here. Oh, did you see her face? It was like a yard of grey.
She don't look like you very much, does she?
She doesn't like anybody.
She's
a dribble
trout.
Oh, shh.
There's a key under here somewhere. I can find it.
Spread!
Shh!
Oh, who's down there then, eh?
It's all right, Sophie, love. It's Grandad.
And who else you with?
No one. Go back to sleep, love.
Yeah. I'll just go and tell my mum. She'll have to hear about this one.
Eight! Oh. How much?
Five, you should do it.
Deal.
We'll square up in the morning then, eh, Grandad? Night.
Night.
You've forgotten something, Bill.
No, just making sure Rosie hasn't slipped herself into my care.
Hey, don't give her ideas.
You're turning your dad's hair grey, you know that.
She's not, where?
Makes you look distinguished.
You mean old?
Hey.
Behave yourself, eh?
I'll try.
Can't you stay a bit longer, Grandad?
I don't know what Maureen would say about that.
Yeah, but we hardly ever see you anymore, and you should just move back to England.
Someone's made an impression.
Yeah, and at about 2:30 this morning, come been round here.
I thought I'd apologise for waking you up about 5 times.
A big night of the dogs, was it?
Brilliant.
Did Audrey like it?
She loved it. Wouldn't surprise me if she didn't sign herself up for membership. Placing bets and drinking out of plastic cups every weekend.
Audrey?
Yeah.
Get off. They're for my mum.
Why grapes?
That's what you give ill people.
Yeah, but why?
Oh, no.
Don't look that ill to me, mate.